You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead.
Hi, my name's Reverend Caroline, and it's really, really lovely to be with you today. I'm trying to think today about what it means to be a good friend and how friendship is really important for us, especially in these times when it's not as easy to keep in touch with our friends as we usually find it. We might not see them every day, and we probably miss them a lot, and they're often on our minds. I want to talk today about how important friendship was to Jesus too, and I want to share with you a story about when Jesus called his friends, which he called the disciples, to come and join him in his ministry, which he spent in the Holy Land for 3 years. So he called his friends from the lake and they joined him. And these friends were called James and John, Andrew and Simon. And they were two sets of brothers. And the story I'm going to read from you is from the Rhyming Bible. And it has a really nice chorus verse, which I'd like you to think that you can join in with me if you'd like to. So I'll start with the chorus, and it's the chorus goes, brother one, brother two, fishing in the sea, brother three, brother four, come and follow me. Jesus walked along the shore of Galilee, and there he saw two brothers fishing in the sea. Leave your nets, said Jesus, leave them, let them be. Come and fish for people, come and follow me. Brother one, brother two, fishing in the sea. Brother three, brother four, come and follow me. So Simon left his nets behind, left them by the sea. Andrew did the same and shouted, hang on, wait for me. Then off they went with Jesus on the shores of Galilee, and there they met some brothers fishing in the sea. Brother one, brother two, fishing in the sea. Brother three, brother four, come and follow me. Those brothers were called James and John, the sons of Zebedee, and Jesus said to them as well, come and follow me. Like that they left their father, surprised as he could be, and left their nets behind as well, sitting by the sea. Brother one, brother two, fishing in the sea. Brother three, brother four, come and follow me. So that's the story of how Jesus called his first four disciples to be with him, to become his friends, and to share a special time with them. And in time, he called up 12 friends, 12 disciples, who spent some very special times with him and accompanied him all the time that he was in the Holy Land. So when we think of, we spell friends, we spell it F-R-I-E-N-D-S. And those five letters, six letters, can help us to make an acrostic, which can help us to think about what is special about our friends too. So the first letter is letter F, for, which reminds us that our friends are faithful to us, and we are faithful to them. The letter R reminds us that friends are reliable. We like being with them because we know that we can trust them to always be there and that they can trust us. And we have the letter I, which shows us that our friends are interesting and interested. They are interesting because we like spending time with them, sharing the things that we enjoy doing, and they like being a part of our interests and our hobbies and being alongside us too. And the letter E is the first word in the letter, enjoyment. So we enjoy being with each other and they enjoy being with us, our friends. We enjoy spending time with our friends. And N, I found N a harder word to find something, but I thought of the word neighbour. Sometimes our friends are physical neighbours, they live close to us. Sometimes we have friends who live further away from us. So the letter N, I think, reminds us of neighbours and neighbourliness. And then the letter D reminds us that our friends are dependable, which is similar to reliable in a way, but our friends are there, meaning that we can depend on them, knowing that they'll always be there. And again, they know that we will always be there. And S can help the, can be the word special. And thus we can think about friends being special in two ways. Our friends are special to us. And sometimes we have a special friend or a best friend who is especially important to us. And perhaps on at these times, it is important to think of ways that will remind us of our good friends while we miss them. Perhaps we can spread kindness and think of our friends with a friendship flower. So this one's for someone called Megan. So you could make something, cut out some paper to make a flower. You could put the name of your friend in the middle, and then you could put all the things that were special about them and all the things that you missed. And that you could then take a picture of it and send it to your friend. Before we close, I'm just going to say a short prayer. Dear God, we thank you for our friends, for the happy times that we share with them. Help us to be a good friend to them. During this time when we can't play with our friends, please help us to find creative ways to keep in touch, to keep them in our minds. Thank you that you are our friend and with us always. Amen.
You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble